Namaste friends, in the previous episodes I talked to you about various resistances that were experienced by a moving vehicle. I also talked about the tractive effort which is required to overcome these resistances. In the present episode I will be talking to you about relationship between tractive effort and speed of the vehicle and the performance curves of a gearbox. This will also explain why a gearbox is essential in an automobile. Referring back something that you have studied in a course related with internal combustion engine. While learning about the performance curves of an engine, you should have studied the relationship between different parameters such as engine torque, engine speed, brake power, fuel consumption, etc. Here I am to talk about the torque, which is measured in Newton meter, and engine speed in RPM. It was represented graphically as shown in the diagram. Nature of curve will remain same even if some other type of engine is considered. The two parameters that are represented in this graph are engine torque in Newton meters and engine speed in RPM, which is actually the rotary speed of the crankshaft. In the previous episode, we have already established a relationship between the tractive effort and engine torque. We have seen that tractive effort is proportional to engine torque. As far as relationship between engine speed and vehicle speed is concerned, it can be done in the following manner. As already discussed, the motion is transferred from engine to clutch, then to gearbox, then to propeller shaft and to differential. From differential it is transferred to live axle, and from live axle it is transferred to the road wheels. Considering N1 to be the gearbox ratio or gear ratio that is available in gearbox, N2 the final drive ratio which is available in differential, we have speed of the road wheel is equal to 1 upon N2 multiplied by speed of the propeller shaft. Speed of propeller shaft is equal to 1 upon N1 into speed of engine shaft. Therefore, speed of road wheel is equal to 1 upon N1 into N2 multiplied by speed of the engine shaft. Therefore, the speed of the road wheel is proportional to the engine speed because N1 and N2 are constant in a particular case. The speed of the road wheel is in RPM or revolution per minute. The road wheel is in frictional contact with the road surface. As the road wheel rotates, it moves on the road surface. In one revolution, the road wheel will be moving a distance of 2 pi capital R meters, where R is the radius of the wheel in meters. If the speed of the road wheel is x RPM, then it will be covering a distance of 2 pi capital R into x meters in 1 minute. If we multiply it by suitable factor, we can convert it into speed in kilometers per hour. Hence, we find that engine speed is proportional to the speed of the vehicle in kilometers per hour. Now, let us discuss about the performance curves. The performance curves that have been referred previously between engine torque and engine speed can be represented for tractive effort and vehicle speed. You may notice that in this graph, the nature of curve is same. Now, let us consider one more gear ratio in gearbox. Practically, in a gearbox, there can be 3, 4, 5 or even more number of gear pairs. These will provide 3, 4, 5 or even more number of gear ratios. But for our purpose, let us consider another pair of gears which is providing us another gear ratio, which we can represent by N2. So we have two gear ratios, N1 and N2. Let us assume that gear ratio N2 is twice the gear ratio N1. The two gear ratios will be giving two curves of tractive effort. These curves are plotted against vehicle speed in the diagram as shown. So here we have the curve AB representing the gear ratio N1. The curve CD represents the gear ratio N2. Let us consider vehicle speed V km per hour and V by 2 km per hour. It can be seen in the graph that tractive effort TN1 corresponding to gear ratio N1 and at vehicle speed V km per hour is half of TN2 corresponding to gear ratio N2 and vehicle speed V by 2 km per hour. Now from the diagram, it can be concluded that by increasing the gearbox ratio 2 times, the tractive effort can also be doubled at half the speed of vehicle. In general, when gearbox ratio is increased, higher tractive effort is available at low vehicle speed. Next, we move to the performance curves related with gearbox. These curves relate the vehicle speed with tractive effort and also the vehicle speed with total resistance experienced by a vehicle. Referring to diagram, it can be seen that different curves are shown for different resistances experienced by a moving vehicle. The variation in total resistance is only because of the different gradient resistance experienced by a moving vehicle. The fact is that air or wind resistance and rolling resistance, the two other components of total resistance, do not vary much. The only difference that occurs is because of the gradient. And because of the higher gradient, the possibility is that vehicle is experiencing more resistance to its motion. So we have considered, say, three different gradients, and corresponding to these gradients, we have curves represented by A, B and C. We have tractive effort represented by curve 1, 2 and 3. Now these tractive efforts represent three different gear ratios. Taking up curve 1, which is for tractive effort, and curve A, which is representing the total resistance for the minimum gradient. So here we find that initially, as the speed increases, we have tractive effort available much more than the total resistance experienced by the vehicle. Say, considering the speed OA, we find that total resistance that is experienced by the vehicle is AY, while the total tractive effort that is available is AZ. So AZ is much more than AY. This is essential to accelerate the vehicle at initial state. Similarly, considering a speed of OB, here we find that the tractive effort that is available is BX, which is equal to the total resistance experienced by the vehicle. So in this case, we find that tractive effort is just sufficient to overcome this resistance. Consider further a speed OC. Here we find that corresponding tractive effort that is available is Cw, and total resistance that is experienced by the vehicle is Cv. Cv is more than Cw, which means that total resistance experienced by vehicle is more than the tractive effort. So obviously a vehicle will not be able to attain the speed OC. The fact is that speed of the vehicle cannot go beyond OB, where the maximum tractive effort is available to overcome the resistance. Now considering second gradient and total resistance experienced by the vehicle represented by curve B, we find that tractive effort available with previous gear ratio is not sufficient to overcome this resistance, and with this vehicle will not be able to move. Therefore we have to have the second gear ratio so that we can get the tractive effort curve 2. Now in this case again we find that in most of the range of total resistance the tractive effort available is more than the resistance, so the vehicle will be able to move. Considering the third situation where gradient resistance further increases, and we have it represented by curve C. So we find that here again the tractive effort which is available because of the second gear ratio is not sufficient and the vehicle will not be able to move. So we have to have the third gear ratio, and corresponding to it we have tractive effort represented by curve 3. So again here we find that the vehicle is capable of moving because the tractive effort available is more than the total resistance experienced by it. Now we have talked about the increase in resistance because of the gradient. So practically we find that whenever we are moving on an inclined surface where we have to overcome a gradient, we have to shift the gear so that the tractive effort available is more than the resistance experienced by the vehicle. So practically when we are shifting to lower gear, we are increasing the tractive effort so that it is able to overcome the total resistance that is experienced by the vehicle when it is moving on the gradient. Now referring back to the figure, considering curve 1 which represents a particular gear ratio, we find that tractive effort available is much more than the total resistance experienced by the vehicle. I have already said that initially it is required to provide good acceleration to the vehicle, but we find that up to the vehicle attains a speed OB, the total resistance is less than the tractive effort available. Now there can be another gear ratio which is providing us the tractive effort which is sufficient to overcome the resistance experienced by the vehicle when it is moving at speed less than OB. So this means that it is better to have four gear ratios. Now perhaps you can conclude from this that four gear ratios are better than three gear ratios. So a gearbox offering more number of gear ratios will be considered better. Now as an extension to this, try to consider the resistance experienced by a vehicle when it moves. It comes across in finite number of situations, and corresponding to each situation it is experiencing a particular amount of resistance to its motion. Ideally a gearbox should provide the sufficient tractive effort to overcome this resistance. This means that gearbox should have infinite number of gear ratios. each providing sufficient tractive effort to overcome the resistance experienced by a vehicle. I conclude this discussion here. In this episode, we have seen the way in which the tractive effort is related to vehicle speed and performance curves relating the tractive effort, total resistance, and vehicle speed. Also, we have realized why gearbox is an essential component of an automobile. Thanks for watching this episode.